हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू द बूस्ट योर बेसिक सीरीज। टुडे वी आर हियर टू डिस्कस द पार्ट 3 ऑफ द ब्लड चैप्टर। इफ यू हैव मिस्ड द अर्लियर पार्ट्स, यू कैन वॉच इट ऑन आवर यूट्यूब चैनल धर्मेश मेहता जी पे। ओके, सो लेट्स स्टार्ट विद टुडेज सेशन। टुडे वी विल डिस्कस फिव इम्पोर्टेंट ब्लड डिसऑर्डर्स। सो फर्स्ट वन इज एनीमिया। एनीमिया इज अ कंडीशन इन विच द ऑक्सीजन कैरिंग कैपेसिटी ऑफ ब्लड इज रिड्यूस्ड। साइंस एंड सिम्टम्स: All of many types of anemias are characterized by reduced number of RBCs or decreased amount of hemoglobin in the blood. Okay, हमें पता है कि जो RBC होते हैं, okay, RBCs which are there, they contain this hemoglobin, right? One RBC contains around 280 million molecules of hemoglobin. Okay, और ये जो hemoglobin होता है, वो oxygen carry करता है, okay, and it use that particular oxygen to various body cells. So, if the amount or the number of RBC are reduced, that means the amount of hemoglobin is reduced. And if the amount of hemoglobin is reduced, that means the oxygen amount is also less, right? And that will lead to hypoxia. Hypoxia meaning lack of oxygen. Then the symptoms are the person feels fatigue. Fatigue yani tiredness, okay? And it is intolerant to cold. And both of these symptoms are due to the lack of oxygen needed for ATP and heat production. Okay. Other symptoms are the skin appears pale, general malaise yani discomfort, then poor concentration. Okay. Then in case of severe anemia, dyspnea can also occur. Okay. Dyspnea yani shortness of breath. Very severe anemia causes the blood to compensate by increasing cardiac output, leading to palpitation, sweatiness, and even to heart failure. Okay. Now we will see the different types of anemias. So first one, iron deficiency anemia. It is the most common type, okay, and it is caused by inadequate absorption of iron or by excessive loss of iron, or due to the increased iron requirement, okay, or by insufficient intake of iron. Women are at greater risk of iron deficiency anemia, okay. This can be due to the heavy loss during the menstruation, heavy blood loss during menstruation, or it can be due to the increased demand for iron, okay, by the growing fetus during the pregnancy. Then gastrointestinal losses such as occurs in with malignancy or ulceration can also contribute to this particular iron deficiency anemia. Then next one is megaloblastic anemia. Okay, it is caused by inadequate intake of vitamin B12, okay, that is the cyanocobalamin, and folic acid, that is vitamin B9, okay, which in turn impairs the maturation of erythrocyte. हमें पता है कि ये जो विटामिन्स है, विटामिन B12 एंड विटामिन B9 आर वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट ड्यूरिंग द प्रोसेस ऑफ एरिथ्रोपोएसिस, राइट? एरिथ्रोपोएसिस यानी फॉर्मेशन ऑफ आरबीसीज, ओके? सो इफ दिस विटामिन्स आर इन इनएडिक्वेट अमाउंट, दैट मींस इट विल इंपेयर द मैच्योरेशन ऑफ एरिथ्रोसाइट, एंड एज अ रिजल्ट द रेड बोन मैरो प्रोड्यूसेस लार्ज abnormal RBCs. Okay, this large abnormal RBCs are megaloblasts. It may also be caused by drugs that alter gastric secretion or are used to treat cancer. The next one is pernicious anemia. It is caused by insufficient hemopoiesis. Hemopoiesis yani the formation of different formed elements, okay, resulting from an inability of the stomach to produce intrinsic factor. Okay, this intrinsic factor is actually required for the absorption of vitamin B12. Okay, and we know that this vitamin B12 is very important for the process of hemopoiesis. Okay, and that's why the deficiency of this particular intrinsic factor will lead to the poor absorption of vitamin B12, and due to this, it will lead to this particular pernicious anemia. Okay, then next one is hemorrhagic anemia. It is caused by excessive loss of RBCs through bleeding. Okay, hemorrhagic yani hemorrhage. Okay, it will lead to the excessive loss of RBCs through bleeding, resulting from large wounds, stomach ulcers, or heavy menstruation. The next one is hemolytic anemia. Okay, It occurs when RBCs are destroyed. Okay, hemolysis. Okay, lysis occurs. That means the RBCs are destroyed while in circulation or are removed prematurely from the circulation because the cells are abnormal or because the spleen is overactive. The condition may result from inherited defects such as abnormal RBC enzymes or from outside agents such as parasites, toxins, or antibodies from incompatible transfused blood. Okay. Then next one is thalassemia. So it is a group of hereditary hemolytic anemia in which there is a deficient synthesis of hemoglobin. Okay. The RBCs are small in this case, that is the microcytic, tail, hypochromic, and short-lived. Okay. The next one is aplastic anemia. It results from destruction of red bone marrow. Okay. It may be caused by toxins, gamma radiations, and certain medication that inhibits enzyme needed for hemopoiesis. Okay. So these are the different types of anemias. Now we'll see the next one, that is erythroblastosis fetalis, that is the hemolytic disease of the newborn. Okay. The other name of erythroblastosis fetalis is hemolytic disease of the newborn. So it is an alloimmune condition. Okay. Alloimmune yani, it is a condition in which the person gets immunity, okay, or gains immunity from another person of the same species against its own cells. Okay, so this particular statement will be more clear when we will discuss this particular disorder or disease. Okay, so it is an alloimmune condition that develops in fetus when the IgG antibodies that have been produced by mother have passed through placenta, include ones which attack the RBC in the fetal condition. Okay. So I will explain you this particular hemolytic disease of the newborn. So if the mother, okay, if the mother is Rh negative, okay, this particular erythroblastosis fetalis is mainly due to the Rh incompatibility. Okay. So if the particular mother is Rh negative, okay, Rh negative, and the fetus which is there is Rh positive. Okay. The fetus which is there is Rh positive. Okay, so what happens when the during the pregnancy, okay, there is a very less chance of interaction between the fetal blood and the maternal blood. Okay, there is a barrier placenta. Yeah, okay, that's why what happens, there is a less amount of, there is no direct contact which occurs between the maternal and fetal blood while the woman is pregnant. But during the delivery, okay, delivery ke time kya hota hai, there are chances of leakage of the fetal blood into the mother's blood. Okay. So that time we know that Rh negative meaning uske pass Rh antigen nahi hai. Rh positive yani fetus ke pass Rh antigen present hai. Okay. So during delivery, what will happen? This Rh antigen which is there, okay, that can leak into the blood of mother. Right. So that's why during the first pregnancy, this particular fetus will not be affected. Okay. The first child will not be affected. Okay. Because the Rh antigen is leaking into the blood of mother during delivery. Right. Okay. So when this Rh antigen will enter the mother's blood, okay, the mother's blood, what will it will do? The immune response will be generated, and because of which the antibodies will be produced, right? Antibodies produce hongi against the Rh antigen. Okay. And if the mother conceives for the second time, okay, during the second pregnancy, again, if the fetus is Rh positive, okay, that time what will happen? The antibodies which are there, okay, anti-Rh antibodies, okay, which are there in the blood of mother, they will cross the placenta, okay? This antibodies can cross the placenta, right? The IgG antibodies can cross the placenta. So, this anti-Rh antibodies which are there, they can cross the placenta, okay? They will enter through the placenta into the fetus, okay? Fetus blood. And there, those antibodies will form a complex with the Rh antigen, okay? Since the fetus is Rh positive, so these antibodies will form a complex with those antigen, Rh antigens, ओके, और हमने पढ़ा था कि वंस द कॉम्प्लेक्स इज फॉर्म, द कॉम्प्लीमेंट सिस्टम और द इम्यून कॉम्प्लीमेंट सिस्टम इज एक्टिवेटेड, एंड दैट पर्टिकुलर कॉम्प्लीमेंट सिस्टम विल मेक द आरबीसीज लिकियर. ओके, दैट मीन्स द आरबीसीज विल रपच्चर. ओके, सो दैट मीन्स इट विल लीड टू द एग्लूटिनेशन इन ऑफ द फीटस आरबीसीज. ओके, सो बिकॉज ऑफ दैट दिस इनकॉम्पेटिबिलिटी इट इज कॉल्ड एज एरिथ्रोब्लास्टोसिस फिटेलिस. ओके, और आरबीसीज रपच्चर हो रहे हैं, राइट, दैट मीन्स हेमोलाइसिस इज ऑकरिंग, दैट्स वाई इट इज कॉल्ड एज हेमोलाइटिक डिसीज ऑफ द newborn. Okay, the red cells are broken down and can develop reticulocytosis and anemia. Okay, severe anemia hoti hai us fetus mein. Okay, the second child which is there, okay, it suffers from severe anemia due to that particular hemolysis of the RBCs. When the disease is severe or moderate, many erythroblasts are present. Okay, and that's why the name erythroblastosis fetalis. Okay, अभी जो हमने पढ़ा, ओके, सेम थिंग्स आर रिटन ओवर हियर. ओके, वी विल जस्ट रीड दिस पर्टिकुलर स्टेटमेंट्स. इट इज कॉज्ड बाय आरएच इनकॉम्पेटिबिलिटी ड्यूरिंग प्रेगनेंसी. इफ द आरएच नेगेटिव मदर कंसीव अ आरएच पॉजिटिव फीटस एंड इफ अ स्मॉल अमाउंट ऑफ आरएच पॉजिटिव ब्लड लीक्स फ्रॉम द फीटस थ्रू द प्लेसेंटा इनटू द ब्लड स्ट्रीम ऑफ आरएच नेगेटिव मदर ड्यूरिंग डिलीवरी, द मदर विल स्टार्ट टू मेक एंटी आरएच एंटीबॉडीज. करेक्ट. Okay, the first baby is usually not affected. Okay, if the mother becomes pregnant again, her anti-RH antibodies can cross the placenta and enter the bloodstream of the fetus. If the fetus is again RH positive, agglutination and hemolysis will be occurring, right? Okay, which is brought on by the fetal maternal incompatibility may occur in the fetal blood. नाउ द प्रिवेंशन एंड प्रिकॉशंस. सो हम क्या करते हैं कि एंड वी आर गिविंग एन इंजेक्शन. ओके, दैट इज द एंटी आर एच एंटीबॉडीज कॉल्ड एज एंटी आर एच गैमा ग्लोब्यूलिन रोगम. ओके, दिस कैन बी गिवन. ओके, ऑल आर एच नेगेटिव वुमन शुड बी रिसीविंग दिस पर्टिकुलर रोगम सून आफ्टर डिलीवरी, मिसकैरेज और एबॉर्शन. ओके, ये जो रोगम है वो ये क्या करता है, जैसे कि हमारी मदर की बॉडी जो है, ओके, वो एंटी आर एच एंटीबॉडी प्रोड्यूस करती है जब उसके ब्लड के अंदर आर एच एंटीजन आता है, राइट. सो दिस पर्टिकुलर इंजेक्शन विच इज देयर, ओके, वो जो मदर की एंटी आर एच एंटीबॉडीज फॉर्म होने से पहले ही अगर हमने ये इंजेक्शन दिया, ओके, इट टेक्स सम टाइम, राइट, फॉर द एंटीबॉडी प्रोडक्शन इट टेक्स सम टाइम. So before only if we give this particular injection, okay, before the formation of anti-RH antibodies by the mother, okay, if we give this particular injection, what will happen? This rogam, okay, this rogam is also containing this anti-RH antibodies. Okay, this will interact and will inactivate the RH antigens which are leaked into the mother's blood during the delivery. Okay. The जो आर एच एंटीजन लीक हुए थे फ्रॉम द फिटस ब्लड ड्यूरिंग डिलीवरी, ओके, दैट विल बी इनएक्टिवेटेड बाय दिस एंटी आर एच एंटीबॉडीज, ओके, विच इज गिवन थ्रू दिस पर्टिकुलर इंजेक्शन. और इसकी वजह से क्या होगा, जो मदर एंटी आर एच एंटीबॉडीज फॉर्म कर रही थी, ओके, उसका जो इम्यून रिस्पॉन्स होगा वो नहीं होगा, राइट, बिकॉज वी हैव ऑलरेडी गिवन दिस एंटी आर एच एंटीबॉडीज. ओके, so that's why it is important to give this particular rogam soon after delivery, miscarriage or abortion. Okay, then leukemia. It is a group of red bone marrow cancers in which abnormal WBC multiply uncontrollably. The accumulation of this cancerous WBCs in red bone marrow interferes with the production of other formed elements like RBCs, okay, platelets, leading to anemia, leukopenia and thrombocytopenia. Okay, this due to this abnormal or cancerous WBCs accumulation in red bone marrow, what will happen, it will interfere with the production of these RBCs, WBCs and platelets. Okay, and that's why it will lead to this anemia, okay, leukopenia and thrombocytopenia respectively. In most leukemias, the cancerous WBCs spread to the lymph nodes, liver and spleen, causing them to enlarge. Symptoms are anemia, weight loss, night sweats, then excessive bleeding, and recurrent infection may also occur. They can be acute anemias, they can be acute leukemias and chronic leukemias. Okay, The causes can be ionizing radiations, then chemicals, genetic factors, microbes, etc. Then next one is sickle cell disease. The RBCs of a person with a sickle cell disease contain HBS. Okay, this HBS is abnormal kind of hemoglobin. When HBS give up the oxygen to the interstitial fluid, it forms long, steep, rod-like structure that bend the erythrocyte, okay, into a sickle shape. These sickle cells rupture easily. Even though erythropoiesis is stimulated by the loss of cells, okay, jab bhi jo erythrocytes hai, yani RBCs hai, wo kam hote hai, that will actually stimulate this particular erythropoiesis process. But this particular process cannot keep up the pace with hemolysis. Okay, a hemolysis jo hai, wo bahut fast hota hai. That's why it cannot keep up the pace with this particular hemolysis. People with sickle cell disease always have some degree of anemia and mild jaundice and may experience joint or bone pain, breathlessness, rapid heart rate, abdominal pain, fever, fatigue as a result of tissue damage caused by prolonged recovery oxygen uptake. Okay, ye sare symptoms hai. Then you can see this is a normal RBC and this is a sickle shaped RBC. Okay. Treatment of sickle cell disease consists of the administration of analgesics to relieve pain. Okay. Then fluid therapy to maintain the hydration, oxygen to reduce the possibility of oxygen death, then antibiotics to counter the infections and blood transfusions. People who suffer from SCD, that is sickle cell disease, have normal fetal hemoglobin, that is HbF. Okay, this is a normal hemoglobin. A slightly different form of hemoglobin that predominates at birth and is present in small amounts thereafter. In some patients with sickle cell disease, a drug called hydroxyurea promotes the transcription of the normal HbF gene. Okay, that is the normal hemoglobin, elevates the level of HbF and reduces the chances that RBCs will sickle. But unfortunately, this drug also has toxic effects on the bone marrow, okay? And thus its safety for a long-term use is questionable. Next one is hemophilia. So hemophilia is an inherited deficiency of clotting in which the bleeding may occur spontaneously or only a minor trauma. It is the oldest known hereditary bleeding disorder. It is a bleeding disorder. Different types of hemophilia are due to the deficiency of different blood clotting factors or exhibit a varying degree of severity ranging from mild to severe bleeding tendencies. Okay, this hemophilia and the earlier one, that is sickle cell disease, okay, they are inheritable diseases. Hemophilia is characterized by spontaneous or traumatic subcutaneous and intramuscular hemorrhaging, then nose bleeding, then blood in the urine, hemorrhages in joints that produces pain and tissue damage. Okay. Then treatment involves transfusions of fresh blood plasma or concentrates of deficient clotting factor to relieve the tendency to bleed. Another treatment is the drug desmopressin. Okay, this can be given, which can boost the levels of clotting factors. Next one is leukocytosis. Okay, leukocytosis, yani it is the raised WBC count above the normal range. Okay, the normal range of WBCs are around 5,000 to 10,000 per microliter, right? So above that, above the normal range, it is called as leukocytosis. And this particular leukocytosis, although it is a sign of illness, it is not a disorder or it is not a disease. Okay, it is simply a laboratory finding. An increase in the number of circulating leukocytes indicates what? Okay, it occurs as a normal protective reaction in a variety of pathological conditions, especially in response to infections. Okay, pathological leukocytosis exists when blood WBC count is more than 11,000 per cubic mm or per microliter, okay, is sustained and is not consistent with the normal protective function. A leukocyte count above 25,000 to 30,000 per cubic mm is termed as leukemoid reaction, okay, which is the reaction of a healthy bone marrow to extreme stress, trauma, or infection. Next one is leukopenia. Leukopenia or leukocytopenia is a decrease in the number of circulating WBCs in the blood. Okay, the total blood leukocyte count is less than 4000 per cubic mm. Okay, that is below the normal range. As the principal function of WBCs is to combat infection, decrease in the number of these cells can place the patient at a higher risk of infection. Okay. Neutropenia is a decrease in the number of circulating neutrophils. Okay, these neutrophils are in abundant WBCs. Etiology, any causes kya hai? The drugs like cytotoxic drugs, then phenothiazine, irradiation, disease of red bone marrow. Okay, these are the causes for leukopenia. The next one is polycythemia. Polycythemia is a condition in which there is a net increase in the total number of RBCs in the blood. This increase in blood viscosity slows the rate of flow and increases the risk of intravascular clotting, ischemia, and infarction. It can be due to relative increase in erythrocyte count. Okay, there is an apparent rise in RBC levels. The underlying cause is reduced blood plasma. And why this reduced blood plasma? It is caused by loss of body fluids, such as through burns, dehydration, and even stress. True increase in erythrocyte count. Okay, it can be either due to relative increase in erythrocyte count or true increase in erythrocyte count. First one, physiological. Prolonged hypoxia stimulates erythropoiesis and the number of cells increased into the normal volume of blood is increased. Okay, the number of cells released into the normal volume of blood is increased due to the increased stimulation of erythropoiesis. This usually occurs in people living at a higher altitudes where the oxygen tension in air is low. Pathological, it may be secondary to other factors that cause hypoxia of the red bone marrow. Example, cigarette smoking, pulmonary disease, and bone marrow cancer. Next one is thrombocytopenia. It is defined as blood platelet count below 150,000 per cubic mm. Often low platelet levels do not lead to clinical problems, but occasionally there may be bruising, particularly purpura in the forearms, the nose bleeds and bleeding gums. Okay. It may be caused by reduced rate of platelet production or increased rate of platelet destruction. So that's it for today. Thank you.